Coming up on Pierce County News.
We started running the routes ahead of time, and then when the snow came in, we were ready.
Meet the team behind the snowplows. See what's trending in your tax statement and growing hothouse rhubarb in Puyallup. Hi, and welcome to Pierce County News. I'm Heather Radall. It was a memorable week for weather when parts of East Pierce County received 8 or more inches of snow, the most we've seen in 5 years. It was all fun and games in this Puyallup neighborhood. The South Hill area saw significant snowfall, about 8 to 10 inches. Bonnie Lake and Buckley saw the most with 12 to 18. Neighborhood streets were buried in snow as road crews worked to open major roads first. If drivers could get out of their development, they were on their way. Over 4 days of snow fighting, Pierce County used 328 tons of salt and plowed more than 1,600 lane miles each day. When snow falls across the whole county, it's all hands on deck for Pierce County road crews. Megan Hutton takes us behind the scenes to meet the managers and see how they decide where snow plows will go.
Pierce County road crews work around the clock during a countywide snowstorm. At the central maintenance facility in Frederickson, inside the road operations center, this is the team behind the snow plows.
We started running the routes ahead of time, and then when the snow came in, we were ready.
They keep a close eye on the weather.
Still into Wednesday, we've got some potential snow forecasted and definitely some low temperatures out into Wednesday.
They are constantly moving crews and equipment around as conditions change.
We can load them with ice slice or take it up to Rhodes Lake Pit and then go back to the quarry at night.
With snow blanketing all of Pierce County, their first priority is clearing those main county roads. Then they can work deeper into neighborhoods.
We just went up and down Canyon Road to keep that clear so we can get people to Canyon Road and then get them to 512 and get them going to work or get them home safely. And then we just really concentrate on those roads. And then when that one's clear, like Canyon, then we'll go back to our map set A, which is more diverse in the zone area, and get people out of their developments.
County roads are divided into 28 zones with a plow truck in each one. They'll run 24/7 during a widespread event like this.
They might not see a plow truck come by for 2 to 3 hours, but they are working and they will be coming by. And just, you know, be patient with us. Stay out of the plow truck's way as they come through. Make sure your kids are out of the way.
When roads are dry, crews can apply a liquid de-icer ahead of freezing temperatures. But if roads are already wet when a snow or ice event hits, they have to spread rock salt over the snow. And this mixes as it melts to create a brine. You'll notice this salt isn't white. It has minerals in it.
It's our first year using it, so we're anxious. It seems like it's going to work out well for us. It'll stick on the roads better. It does have a little more cutting power than just basic salt.
Pothole repairs will be the next big focus after this round of freezing and thawing weather. You can call the Road Operations Center to report roads that need plowing, waters or trees over the road, and potholes. The number is 253-798-6000. Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.
It's time to take your taxes to heart. Pierce County is mailing out property tax appraisals this month, and as reporter Matt Samsel tells us, there are some things to love about it.
On or sometime around Valentine's Day, property owners will get their property tax appraisals in the mail from the Pierce County Assessor Treasurer's Office. Assessor Treasurer Mike Lonergan says taxes will go up in some areas due to school bonds, fire levies, and the new Sound Transit tax that voters passed in November. Lonergan estimates 4 out of 5 homeowners will see a tax increase.
The value of housing continues to go up and up, then the rate, even though it's lower, times the value equals a somewhat higher tax, somewhere in the range of 4% to say 11% higher, depending where you live in the county.
To avoid any penalties or late fees, the best advice is don't procrastinate and meet your deadlines.
The first payment is normally due the last of April, but that's a Sunday this year, so we actually give people one more day to pay the first half of their taxes, which is May 1st deadline. Then the second half will be due October 31st.
There's a couple of options for one-on-one help.
Yes, good afternoon. This is Linda with the Pierce County Assessor Treasurer's Office.
Taxpayers can call the Assessor's Customer Service Center for any questions, or you can visit the website for further information and live chat option, or just visit the office in person. I'm Matt Samsel, Pierce County News.
If you live in University Place, the city is gathering information on marijuana uses and what areas might be considered for pot businesses in the future. In Washington State, cities are allowed to ban marijuana retail stores, and University Place did so. But now that may change at the state level. The city is examining what commercial areas could be appropriate for marijuana businesses. Recently, the City Council asked the University Place Planning Commission to seek public opinion on marijuana uses. A public meeting was held to gather feedback and provide recommendations regarding existing city zoning and regulations.
The state does allow certain buffers around certain sensitive receptors, such as daycares and parks, to be reduced down to 100 feet, from 1,000 down to 100. And the general consensus of the people that showed up is that they felt that there should not be any reduction in the size of the buffers.
A final decision on marijuana uses will be made by the UP City Council. No date has been set at this time. Black mold is forcing the city of Fife to relocate their public and city council meetings to a temporary location. The black mold was discovered last year on the outside and inside of the council chamber walls. Heavy exposure to black mold can cause health problems. A contractor will remove the mold-contaminated areas, and reconstruction will begin later this month. While the work is being done, Fife City Council meetings will be held at the Fife School District Boardroom, located east of Fife High School.
So the same meeting room that the Fife School Board meets, they have been kind enough to offer to our council, and so our meetings will proceed at the regular times, second and fourth Tuesday business meetings, and third Tuesday study sessions, in the Fife School Board meeting room.
The Fife School District office is located at 5802 20th Street East, and the council will meet there over the next 4 months. Blount says the work should be finished by mid-June. Whether you're a senior receiving Social Security now or you plan to in the future, it's important to know about a shortfall in payments that's less than 20 years away. People are living an average of 25 years longer than they did when Social Security was created in the 30s. 9 out of 10 seniors today rely on their monthly payments to make ends meet. 30% of retirees have no savings at all. If nothing is done to update Social Security, seniors, baby boomers, and future generations will have to rely less on these benefits.
So around the year 2035, 2034, Social Security will hit a wall where it has a shortfall and is only able to pay about 77% of all the earned benefits that people have.
Receiving 23% less each month would be a big hit for most seniors. That's why Pierce County Community Connections is holding a series of workshops called Updating Social Security. The workshops discuss 12 ideas for keeping Social Security sustainable into the future.
That no one of these 12 solutions will of themselves do the trick. It's going to take a combination of things. And secondly, that we need to engage in a conversation with our elected representatives in Congress.
To learn more and have your questions answered, head to a workshop on Saturday, February 11th at 10 a.m. at the Soundview Building in Tacoma. Or you can reach out to the Pierce County Aging and Disability Resource Center, or go online to the Social Security Administration website. As more and more seniors become web savvy, there are a lot of online resources available for Social Security, including tax documents. Joining me today is Kirk Larson. He is with the Social Security Administration. Kirk, a lot of people are concerned about Social Security. What is the best way for them to get information?
Good question. And we try to may have a number of different resources for people, depending on how they want to get information. So of course, we have our network of offices here in Pierce County. We have the Tacoma office and the Puyallup office. So you can go in to get information. You can also call our 800 number, which is open from 7 in the morning till 7 at night. That's 800-772-1213. So you can give them a call and they'll assist you. Or one of the best ways to get information is to go right online. You don't have to go someplace, you don't have to wait on the phone. You can just get right online and get the information at our website. So that, I always recommend people that if you want to learn about Social Security, that's the best place to go ahead and start.
Let's talk about some of those online resources. What can they learn and what's available?
One of the greatest tools that they can use is our online services, the My Social Security account. You can go right online there and learn all about your benefits. So if you're not getting benefits, you can go online, you can see what your future retirement benefits would be, if you became disabled, what you could qualify for, if you were to pass away, what your survivors could receive. You can review your work history and see year by year how much money you've made. And if you're on benefits, it's even better. If you need to work with Social Security, you can go right online, you can change your address, change your phone number, change your direct deposit. You can get a benefit verification letter. You don't have to go into an office. You can find out what your benefits are in case you have to give some documents to someone to confirm what your income is. You can get that. And if you need to get a replacement Social Security card or a replacement Medicare card, you can do all that right online.
Oh my gosh, I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
What about tax documents? Because I know taxes are coming up.
Yeah, that's something that's always coming up. And potentially for some people, Social Security benefits are taxable. So very important that you get your Social Security 1099 form. And if you don't have that handy, you can go right online and print up a copy of that. Or if you need to prove what your Social Security benefits are, you know, if you're getting a loan or you're doing something through HUD or something like that, you can actually print up a benefit verification letter. Don't need to go into an office. Can get it whenever you need it.
And what about any new changes for 2017 that we might want to know about?
One of the biggest changes we had is in 2016, we didn't have a cost of living increase, but this year we did have a cost of living increase, and benefits didn't go up a great deal because there wasn't a great deal of inflation in the economy. Went up about 0.3%.
This is a lot of information, but I know that you have workshops where people could actually come in person and learn about this. Let's talk about that.
Exactly. And one of the workshops that's coming up, I have one in April that's taking place in Federal Way. I encourage people to come on down for that. And also in July, we're having a special workshop here in Tacoma on disability benefits. But, you know, you don't have to wait till the workshops. If you want to learn about benefits, you can call us. You can go right online. That's the best place to get information.
You do make it easy. Thank you.
Thank you.
Coming up next, the trick to growing the hothouse variety of rhubarb and what makes those stalks so red. We're back in just 60 seconds.
We are there, day one, with baby names and a gift that lasts a lifetime. We are there as you grow, protecting you and those you love. We are there when you get your first job, helping you to save for the future. We are there when you marry your sweetheart, to help secure your new life together. We are there if the unexpected happens, to help you see life from a new perspective. We are there when you become a full-time grandparent or the author of your next chapter to make sure you get off to a great start. And we are there when you lose your soulmate to help make sure that you will be all right. We are with you through life's journey. We are Social Security, securing today and tomorrow.
Growing rhubarb has been a staple on the Richter family farm since the 1930s, but it's the hothouse variety that's helping Tim Richter farm year-round. We visited this Puyallup farm to see the bright red stalks for ourselves in our series, Meet the Farmer.
Inside this dark hothouse, the temperature is a mild 55 degrees. That's warm compared to the cool February winter of the Puyallup Valley.
We brought these plants in here, you know, in December. and then we've turned on the heat, and then 30 days start picking. And so we've been picking in here since roughly, you know, about the 20th of January. And our schedule is picking every week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
100-pound root balls are grown for 2 years out in the field before being brought inside. Over a few months, the plants shoot up stalks looking for light, but with no sun to feed the plant, all the energy goes into the deep red stalk.
The interior of a field-grown rhubarb is kind of on the green side, and then it's a lot stringier. In the house, the stick is, you know, all red, pink, makes beautiful sauce.
So what do you make with hothouse rhubarb? Mostly pies, crisps, and sauces. And as I discovered, you really need to mix it with sugar.
How would you describe that?
Almost like a sour apple.
Yeah, a little bit.
A little bit.
Yeah.
With the texture of celery.
Yeah.
This is considered the pie plant, and for good reason, it makes delicious pies.
Richter also grows summertime crops like lettuce, jalapenos, and cilantro. But with hothouse rhubarb, he can be a year-round farmer, and it brings in revenue so he can retain a core group of 15 workers.
I can keep them busy 40 hours a week, and they're happier, and you know, you gotta keep your labor happy, or you're not gonna have a very successful farm or business, period.
Hothouse rhubarb is the first local fruit on the market. Workers remove the leaves, but keep the crow's feet. Consumers buy with their eyes, and there is high demand for Richter's extra fancy, bright red stalks.
We have two grades, extra fancy and fancy, and that's based upon the girth and color, and the extra fancy being the bigger and the more red.
80% of what's picked will be shipped to the East Coast and the San Francisco Bay Area.
It's fun to sell something people want.
Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.
Up next, basketball and slow pitch season is almost here. But first, here are some dates for your calendar. Runners can take their mark and register for Tacoma's Valentine's Run on February 11th. There's a 5K run for the grown-ups and a one-mile dash for the kiddos. You can register on the day of the race. For more information, go to metroparkstacoma.org/Valentine Run. Get your dancing shoes ready for the annual Daddy-Daughter Dance brought to you by University Place Parks and Recreation. This year's dance will be at Curtis High School on February 11th. All ages are welcome. For more information, call 253-566-5710. This week, Jen Sargent has the registration details you don't want to miss. Hi, Jen.
She shoots. Oh, and she scores. Hey, Heather, did you know that our recreation program is a great place for your kids to learn about basketball? Registration for youth basketball is open February 13th through March 31st. It's for boys and girls ages 5 through 8. Practices are held one evening a week, and all games are on Saturdays at Lakewood Community Center. The season runs from April to June. Go online to register. Registration is opening soon for our adult slow pitch leagues. Don't let your kids have all the fun. Sign yourself up for a men's or women's league. Registration is open February 27th through March 31st. Get a $30 discount before March 13th. Games are played at Sprinker and Heritage Recreation Centers. One of these times, I'm really going to impress you. Oh, but not this time. I'm Jen Sargent for Pierce County News. Back to you, Heather.
You can do it, Jen. Come on. You can see Pierce County from here on PCTV. We have the original programming that you can't find anywhere else. For more local focus, hear local groups discuss the need for more civility in our world and the difference we can make in Pierce County. Catch it at 10 in the morning on Sunday or 5 in the evening on Monday on PCTV. I'm Heather Radall. Thanks for watching Pierce County News.